Recognize that? You should do if you follow this man's channel. I'm finally down here in Lakeland at Sun and Fun, and look who I bumped into. Hello, mate.
Hey, buddy.
How you going?
I'm going to be great.
Good.
That's it. Locked.
That's too cool. I don't have one of those.
Now, we just flew in together in Niko's amazing new SR22 Turbo. We obviously filmed it and we made a video of that. I'm going to put that on the channel probably in a couple of weeks' time because we had like 328 cameras going and it's just going to be like a bit of an interesting edit. So that's coming on the channel. But we're finally down here in Lakeland, Florida, down here at the air show. You excited?
I'm so excited.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't wait.
Yeah, me too. I'm looking forward to checking it out. Let's go and have a look and then we'll catch up with Niko a little bit later on today.
Let's do this.
And once again, after traveling halfway across the globe via a final flight from Niko, thanks to Niko for that. Again, that video is going to be on the channel in the next week or two, but welcome back. Here we are once again, Sun and Fun 2019. Of course, no air show sequence would be complete without me applying sunscreen in front of the camera as I talk to you about what I'm doing down here and what's going to be in the video. So I wouldn't want to disappoint. Yes, once again, I find myself in the middle of a field somewhere applying sunscreen, surrounded by planes. Basically, it's kind of my happy place, right? Now, I was at Sun and Fun last year in 2018. I'll link to the playlist up above from the videos from 2018 if you want to watch those. You may ask, why come to the same air show the other side of the world, spend all that money? Basically, when you were here this time last year, is it going to be any different? Well, probably not, is the answer. I mean, air shows these days, they are quite similar. I mean, even the layout is very similar to what I saw last year. The people who are exhibiting are similar to last year. The pilots who are flying, that's Mike Goodin in the background, are similar to last year as well. But the point is not just to come and expect to see something different. The point is I enjoy this. I love being in this environment. And even if it is roughly the same thing as I saw last year with a few variances, A, I'm getting out and doing something which I love and enjoy. B, I've got an opportunity to meet up with a bunch of friends, people I've made friends with over the last 12 months since being here at Sun and Fun last time, so I'm excited to catch up with them as well. And finally, look, I wanted to try out those long haul carriers as well, Singapore Airlines, the last video that was on this channel, AirAsia as well. And it's just the experience of traveling, of moving, of going somewhere, and ending up in a field, in the middle of nowhere potentially, but ending up at an air show, just surrounded by the things I love so much. That's why I've done it again this year. That's why I'm here again. And that's why I'm really grateful that you're following along with these vlogs. All right, let's go see some planes. Even though clearly there's a whole bunch of aircraft for me to see, there's some really rare aircraft, some vintage aircraft, warbirds. We all know where I'm going to start, right? End up hanging around with my favorite sort of aircraft. I also bumped into this guy who you may recognize from YouTube.
Glad to have you from all the way around the world.
I know, all the way from Australia to here. It's a long trip to get here, but it's brilliant. I'm having a great day so far.
That's awesome.
Steve-O, as we know, is a newly converted Cirrus pilot. You're going to only fly Cirrus from now on, is that right?
I don't know if that's really the case, but I do love the SR22 Turbo. It's one of my favorite airplanes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because you've been flying them a little bit around. If you don't follow Steve-O, and most of you who follow me obviously will follow this guy too, but I'll link to your channel down below. You've got some Cirrus videos on there as well.
Awesome.
What else are you up to at the moment? What else are you flying? Any plans?
Flying a brand new Bonanza coming up in the Bahamas. We're going out to the Bahamas in the Cirrus in 2 weeks from now.
Cool.
They're going to do some bone fishing. It's a type of fishing out in the Bahamas that they do.
Yeah.
It's a lot of fun. So we've got a lot of good videos coming up.
Awesome. What are you up to at the show then?
Later this week, Sun and Fun, I'm going to be flying extra 300s, formation aerobatics. So we're going to be doing that. It'll be a lot of fun.
Wow.
Pull some G's.
Oh, nice to see you, mate.
Yeah.
Take it easy. Just been watching a few of the air displays this afternoon as the sun slowly starts. It's the Aeroshell display team.
just as the sun's slowly starting to come down, because I'm actually staying here. Actually, no, just with being interrupted by planes, you know what it's like when you come to an air show and you're talking to someone, you're having that conversation, but you have to keep stopping every 30 seconds just whilst the planes are. So you go, how you going? Yeah, I've been really well, thanks. How's the family? Yeah, we'll talk later. Anyway, yeah, sun's coming down. The night show that's on tonight, they do a night show two nights here at Sun and Fun on the Wednesday night tonight and Saturday night. Now, because I'm leaving Florida early on Sunday morning, I'm not going to stay around for the Saturday night show. So tonight's my only opportunity to stay around for a night show. I've never been to a night show at Sun and Fun, and I figured whilst I'm making these vlogs, you might like to see some of the action that goes on, not just in daytime, but in the dark. So stick around for that. That's my steps goal done for the day. Regular viewers of the channel will know that I am actually a vegetarian. Don't unsubscribe, don't hold it against me, but it does mean that sometimes at air shows it's a little bit hard to find something to eat. So there now follows a sequence of me going to the air show food outlets, trying to find something suitable to eat, which isn't chips. Although I could well do with some chips right now. Hey! Probably not. Italian sausage. A twisted willy? What the hell? Chili willy. I think it's coming down to a choice of pizza, a pretzel. I think I can discount a chili willy though.
Am I just gonna get a margarita pizza?
There you go.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, have a nice day.
That was a good pizza. See, the fun thing is now that the air show itself has stopped, it stops at 5:30 and starts again at 7:30. So there's this short window where anyone who's flown in their own aircraft can now leave. And so this is like queues of traffic like you'd get on the freeway, aviation style. Look at this. And then whilst they're queuing, look at everyone else who's taking off in the background as well. They've got two parallel runways in operation at the moment. It's very well organised. Night show's about to start. Oh no, I keep getting the shadow of the camera in my face. That's not very professional. The night show's about to start now at Sun and Fun. I know a couple of things that are going to be on, but I haven't actually looked at the schedule on purpose, because once again, I want to kind of enjoy the moment as well and maybe be a bit surprised myself by what's coming up. So I know a couple of things which I definitely want to film and share with you. But yeah, let's go and find a place to sit and yeah, let's enjoy the night show at Sun and Fun. Never done this before.
From 120 miles per hour, under canopy now at about 22 miles per hour, he's got a view like you would not believe. He loves Sun and Fun.
But just when all seemed black and dire, they made a tiny spark. With moss and wood coaxed into fire, man now ruled the dark. All eyes turned toward the starlit sky with music, fire, and light.